It's the time to get down. Zach Zound, the Body Heat, doing it to you in your sleep, coming to you live from that Neil Urban Cyber Street. We're back stereo. Yeah, that's Lalah Hathaway, everybody, as captured by Victor Allen, produced, directed, the LZ, Local Zone. We's out there on the scene. Lalah, Miss Lalah, and friends. Rachelle Farrell, Vesta Williams, that was something else. We're going to have another piece later on in the show. Yeah. What's up? Baldwin Hills, Crenshaw Plaza.
Yes, sir.
Man.
What an experience, man. I didn't get to get my my Chinese food. Oh, you know, I needed to get something to eat, and nobody would kind of go get me something to eat.
Well, hey, that's right. I heard they were just pinching you on the butt. You know, Vic has to go through a lot. See, people don't realize. Well, now that we get accessed and we get invited to cover these things, it still is part of the Neil Urban milieu, as it were, to mix with the crowd, to mingle, to get some sort of a little zone to shoot. So people don't, you know, they don't know. They see with the camera. They like to tap you on the shoulder. Hey, man.
Yeah.
So, Vic, tell them about some of your adventures.
It's so funny because, you know, when you're in your community, people want to shout out. And look, I'll never say don't say hello, but it is funny how people reach out sometimes. Now, it can be a mistake now and then, but then you just have to kind of look at it for what it is. So, Turquoise was sitting next to me. I'd say, okay, you need to be right here. Let me get right here. And then all of a sudden, something reached out, bam, on my butt. Now, I got happy butt for a moment. It didn't work, not the way I thought. But she got to witness what I keep telling people about is when we're shooting, it's amazing when somebody wants to get your attention.
Yeah, right.
Then when you see the camera shake, you know why. The butt got pinched.
Man, the zipper stuck.
No,
I understand.
So
I know.
It was.
Man.
It's one of those things that you live with it, and I don't mind, man, because, you know, they can just totally ignore you.
Well, what a so it's a tired job, but someone has to
do it. Thank you. Yeah, I know, man. It's always good. It's always good. I love it, man. But I know you can't wait for what's coming up, right?
Man, because it was such a busy weekend, so it's time.
Uh-huh.
For the new news sports. All about sports and sweating and speaking. All about jock itch and all about sports bras and girls say they bringing something in next time it's good. Hey, we
right. Yeah. Well, I don't know if this is a good segment or just a segment to transition to a segment after those kind of intros,
man. But it's the way you do it, Vic. I had to come up with something worthy.
Yeah, I know.
Something worthy of the wonderful sports reporting that you prepare every day, just like the hot picks. You slave, your fingers to the bone, your eyes glued to the monitor.
Yes, sir.
Your ear to the wind.
Trying to do something, man.
Just to be able to tell us.
What's up in sports?
What's up in sports?
Well, since we don't have an argument crowd in here now, we get to talk about sports as if we know what we're talking about.
Yeah.
And, okay, I tell you what. I'm going to give you three names. No, I'm not going to give you any names. I'm just going to let you know this. There was the hot topic of sports this weekend. And I hate to say this. It's kind of hard to pick your ones, but I'm going to throw out some names, and you let me know which one you think ranked number one.
Okay.
We got Denny Hamlin, NASCAR. He takes over first place against Jimmy Johnson, the four-time winner. You got Zenyatta.
That was number six.
That's number you six. Got Zenyatta the horse, who I got to give props to. That horse is damn good.
She's named after this old girlfriend of mine from Compton.
You got Brett Favre, who finally got a reprieve. I mean, on the overtime game. And the one I thought caught everybody by surprise, Peyton Manning versus Michael Vick.
Well, hey, it's Peyton Manning, but it's also, it's not that just that Brett Favre got a reprieve. No, Brett Favre got the coach a reprieve.
I don't know.
That was the hot one, Vic.
You think
it
so?
It was a lot of hot stuff in professional football, but Vic,
right.
It wasn't just even professional football because, once again, like I have to admit,
right.
College football had upsets, but it was the first week
right.
where you didn't have a shift in the BCS rankings, right?
You know you did. You had one minor shift, and it was TCU, who TCU reminds me of an Oregon Ducks football team with better defense. That's who they are to me. So, yeah, they just swapped out with Boise State.
Okay.
So,
okay.
I mean, but you know what? Look, you were on it, though.
Well, it's a weekend of football.
Right.
You're right. Not NASCAR and some NASCAR.
Right.
You know, you got to get to NASCAR. Well, you love NASCAR.
Well, I love NASCAR.
I haven't seen a Confederate flag in a while.
But you got to understand. I think, honestly, I mean, I know football.
I hate those announcements.
When you're going that fast on those cars, and then you start paying attention to the nuances and what they're doing, it's amazing what they have to do to try to adjust from not basically killing themselves to me. That's what they're on. Road rage on crack. NASCAR is.
That's what, and you know what, we talked about it, that NASCAR was actually born out of the rum runners.
That's right.
Through the South, you know, when you think about it, who were souping up the cars to do the,
that's right,
deliver the alcohol during Prohibition.
Yeah. So, I mean, I follow them because there is a competition. They're trying to create more competition so people can follow it. And they have two more races. And the guy that everybody's going after, Jimmy Johnson, it basically now is in second place for the first time in the late part of the season. So there's going to be a head-to-head matchup in the next two races. And if you want to see excitement, the way that it deals with jockeying, people getting bumped, there was already in this last race, Jeff Gordon and had a fight. It was an attempt to be a fight. Yeah, and I can't remember the guy's name. See, this is bad.
Well, here's the thing.
Sports reporting.
Which one is going to have their own sausage? Somebody's got to have it. We need some more sausage.
He's talking about Jimmy Dean. You're talking about something like Jimmy Dean sausage.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go to the next one. We're going to go to the next one. Let's go up. Okay, Michael Vick. No, honestly, Michael Vick, you tell me. Michael Vick not only came out, and the stats don't really.
That's a different story. I didn't know it. Did you hear about that?
Wait a minute.
Vic is the first to break that story. This is a breaking news here.
Wait a minute.
Breaking news here.
Here we go. See, this is the part where I get it. See, when anybody leans over that much to get sound effects, you know they got a problem. All right. Let's just say he performed and he outperformed Peyton Manning.
Oh, okay.
Okay, 58.
I'm about to say something else.
Well, you know, first of all,
Dad, can you get a YouTube video?
Well, I got to warn everybody. When the women are not here, we pretend like they're here, and we allude to sex.
We think
sports always is wrapped around with some kind of sexual rapping. Always.
I brought some of my blow-up friends. They are here.
See, this is what I'm saying.
The blow-up dates.
So here's the part. Michael Vick. He goes 17-29, 1 TD, 58.6% as far as his pass completion. Peyton Manning, 31-52, 59.6%, 1 TD, 2 interceptions. What, if anything, was shocking about this? If you were shocked that what everybody had predicted, that the Colts would defeat the Eagles.
Well, you know what it was, that we expected it to be a blowout, kind of. It was only that Indiana didn't score as much as we probably thought they would have. Actually, had they scored another two touchdowns, it would have then been closer to what I would have expected.
Yeah, yeah. And look, and the part that everybody's recognizing is the elevation of Michael Vick's game. In other words, he didn't take too many chances. He's not trying to throw his body out there to get, you know, a hit and an injury.
Safe sex, Michael.
Yeah, I don't know if he's into...
Put a helmet on that soldier. Don't take chances. Not like those people over 50.
It's part of just...
They take a lot of chances.
Sometimes you let people rant. Let them have their moment.
I just want them to know.
Yeah, that moment. Okay. Well, all right. So here's the part that I like. They're saying that there's a good chance that Michael Vick basically, you know, can continue to improve because his leg speed, he's smarter. And even with the weakness in the defense on the Philadelphia Eagles, I didn't expect them to really defeat the Colts. I really thought that Peyton Manning, even with his injuries, which the Colts have a lot of injuries, and he's working with like a second crew, that they still would get away with a better defense. The Colts' defense is better than the Eagles.
Well, you know, I kind of agree, but I still kind of thought, I was still kind of felt like Philadelphia was going to score close to 20 points at least.
Yeah, I
just thought that the Indiana was going to score like 35.
More. Yes, you and I are on the same page. I thought the same. I didn't see Manning throwing two interceptions. I really didn't, because you're talking about the Eagles' defense that's not known.
Right.
So to throw two interceptions, even with a secondary receivers, that he still would chop them up down the road and basically say, we're going to go down the field, we're going to eliminate our turnovers, and we're just going to beat them on playing a scheme around the field and let Philadelphia implode on his secondary. I didn't think this was going to be this way. Now, here's the next one. Favre. Now, I have to go to Favre because this is leading up to this story as it relates to where we think who's got the better chance to make it to the playoffs, because Favre got his reprieve. Now, I know you said the coach.
I say the coach got a reprieve. I know you said. Because that's the one whose ass was on the line. The coach. I mean, Favre would have been like, hey.
Right.
You know, he could be gracious. He could be a four. But really, the coach's ass.
Right.
And Favre, you know, saved the coach's ass by having one of his great days.
Well, here's the part that
one
I
of
still.
His great days. I supposedly, that was the best day ever, right? 400-some yards?
That's right. And his most prolific day. So, yeah, you're right to a certain degree that, Mark, I believe he did. He gave a reprieve to the coach. Yes, I agree.
440. You have it here, Vic. You're so wonderful with your stats here. 446 yards, Vic.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. The most prolific day of his career.
That's correct.
Of his 20-year career. And two touchdowns.
To get past Arizona.
Man, the old man. Let's hear it for Brett Favre, everybody.
Now, are you cheering?
Hey, Brett Favre. Yeah, man, I'm a Brett Favre fan. He's damn right. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, Brett.
Will you cheer? You're cheering
captain.
Wait a minute. Are you cheering for a man that played against a lesser team, the Arizona Cardinals?
I don't care whoever he played against.
Who is almost last or in the lower part.
He reminds me of me.
Of defense.
Come on, Brett. I'm like Brett. Old veteran. Tried and true. Steady tall.
You're going. Yeah. That's the rebellion right there. Yeah, okay.
Go, Brett.
Well, look. First of all, I agree. I agree that, you know, he stood up against this team.
It's wonderful.
Arizona's not, you know.
I'll take it against anybody, Vic.
Okay, well, then let me bring the one that is your shocker, because you really thought this team was the team to beat, and that was New England got swamped by the Cleveland Browns.
I don't even know. I got to see it. If I could get the replay to where we don't have that.
You have to see it.
I have to see it.
You have to see it. 34-14, when you see how they just ran through them, it was like everybody, their front four in Cleveland, is good on defense.
Well, I have to say, it has to be a beast here, because not only did they manage to score a lot of points, they also limited New England to 14 points.
So what did I tell you?
I didn't get a chance to see any of that.
I know.
I saw some highlights.
Yeah, I saw some highlights, and I went to look at some footage here, but I didn't get to see the whole game. But what you could see is that they literally just had their way with the team. I mean, when I say literally, the running back.
That sounds nasty, Vic. Don't want to have your way with people.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. Something usually involves some body fluid.
Well, here's the thing.
It's pretty disgusting.
To keep you off track.
Yeah.
To keep you off track. Okay. You tell me. You crazy, man. You tell me. Is New England the real deal, or have they been exposed?
I think they're the real deal. I think it just shows everybody's what's happening. This is the year of this.
You think so?
Yeah. Yeah. Look at, and I'm still going, hey, go Tampa Bay.
And they lost.
I know. I still say go.
You still say?
In other words, it's an upside. Look at this.
Right.
The Dallas Cowboys are next to the worst team in the whole league.
Right.
Right above Buffalo. Right.
Right. And Buffalo keeps losing only by small points. So they're consistent, but they're right like 3 points short, losing by 3 points, 6 points, 1 point, overtime. They're a better team performing at zero wins than the Cowboys, for obvious reasons. That's just my opinion, man.
All right. All right, so